哈利路亚！再次向我们诸位在座主耶稣所引领的好朋友，还有诸位主所爱在基督城这里的圣徒们，大家论坛。感谢主再次将地面上的安息圣日赏赐给我们。愿主耶稣能够纪念你们的信心，大大赐福给在座诸位。今天上午我们的题目是：你是主所爱的门徒吗？新约圣经里面有一卷经文叫约翰福音。所谓的福音就是记载了耶稣还活着时候他说的话做的事。那么这个约翰福音记录下来的人，他在经文当中自称为主所爱的门徒。
He called himself the beloved disciple of Christ.
我们先一起来看约翰福音十三章。
Let us all turn to John chapter 13.
二十三节。
Verse 23.
十三章的二十三节。
13 verse 23.
有一个门徒是耶稣所爱的，侧身挨进耶稣的怀里。请翻译，再把这一节念一次。
So chapter 13, verse 23. One of his disciples looked at one another, uncertain of whom he was speaking. Of 23, one of his disciples, the one whom Jesus loved.
这里说有一个门徒是耶稣所爱的，其实这个门徒就是约翰福音的作者。
So here it mentions one of his disciples, the one whom Jesus loved, that refers to the author of John.
我们再来看约翰福音十九章。
We turn to John chapter 19.
二十六节。
Verse 26.
十九章二十六节。
Chapter 19, verse 26.
耶稣见母亲和他所爱的那门徒站在旁边，就对他母亲说：“母亲，看你的儿子。”
When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, "Woman, here is your son."
我们接着再看约翰福音二十一章第七节。
We continue to turn to chapter 21, verse 7.
二十一章第七节。
Chapter 21, verse 7.
耶稣所爱的那门徒对彼得说：“是主。”那时西门彼得赤着身子，一听见是主。就束上一件外衣，跳在海里。
That disciple whom Jesus loved said to Peter, "It is the Lord." When Simon Peter heard that it was the Lord, he put on some clothes, for he was naked, and jumped into the sea.
我们刚才在那三节经文里面看到的这个门徒
，And in these three verses, it mentions disciple.
也是在约翰福音这卷经书里面找不到名字的门徒。
It does not refer to their name in this book of.
于是后来我们这些查考圣经的人就开始推论了。
So, the people who study the Bible, they begin to theorize.
这一卷福音书当中，那位主所爱的门徒应该就是使徒约翰。
That this disciple whom Jesus loved, it should be referring to disciple John.
但就在这个为他证明的过程啊，为他寻找名字的过程当中。
In this process of trying to find his name,
我们恐怕也会失去了这一个福音书当中他故意没有名字的美好意思。
We may also lose the purposeful meaning of not having a name.
那为什么故意没有名字呢？
And why would there be no name on purpose?
所以我们暂时不要把它想成是使徒约翰。
So for now, we won't think of it as
我们就让真理的圣灵来带领我们，也借着经文的引导，让这个没有名字的门徒维持他的原意，好让我们得到造就， 因为这一个没有名字的门徒，他自称是主所爱的。
Because this disciple without a name, it's self-proclaimed is one that's loved by.
所以我们来思考，在经文当中记载他到底做了什么呢
？So, what did he actually do?
那也让我们思考，我们是不是这位神所爱的
？And that leads us to think, are we the one that God loves?
好，那这位门徒，他当然就是我们所称的基督徒啊。
So this disciple is a Christian.
那基督徒如何看待自己的名字呢
？And how does a Christian see his own name?
我们每个人都有自己的名字。
We all have our own names.
但是我们怎么想，别人怎么想
？But what do we think and what do others think?
我们先想想世界上的人，他们都很看重自己的名字。
In this world, people all place emphasis on their own name.
所以啊，我们在华人世界有一句俗话这么说了。
So in the Chinese language, there is a saying.
叫做老虎死掉了，我讲白话一点，虎死留皮，人死留名啊。
So when a tiger dies, they leave their skin, and when a person dies, they leave their name.
对呀，这一句俗谚说出了千古以来一般世人渴望在人世留名的心态。
So this is a mindset that people have. They want to leave their name in this world.
所以我们被生娃娃坠地之后啊
，So when we are born into this world，
我们便不分日夜劳碌的在往留名的路上来奔驰。
We are constantly working on a path towards leaving our name.
那一般能在历史上留下名字的人呢
？And for the people who have managed to leave the
他们可以说都是当时代社会里面的眷恋，就是杰出人士啊。
They are often the ones who stand out in society at the time.
但是大部分的人似乎不能够名留青史，没有办法名字留在历史上。
But most people cannot leave their name behind in history.
可是他依然有这种渴望。
But they still have this want.
于是我们发现有些人在他所到的地方啊，不管是用刻的、用喷漆的，会写某某人到此一游。
So often we'll see somewhere on a wall that someone would write, someone was here.
借这样子来聊表他的心意，其实这个不是一个很好的事情啊。
To show their heart, but this is not actually a very good thing.
所以每个人都希望自己能够跟那些古代的名人一样。
So everyone hopes to be like the people in the past.
甚至跟那一些存留很久的古迹一起留在人的记忆当中。
Or even a famous historical figure who will stay in people's minds.
所以人呢，自然有这种追求不朽的意识。
So people have this mindset to pursue.
这是显而易见的。
This is obvious.
所以啊，在华人的哲学思想里面，曾经有这么一个论调。
So in the Chinese philosophical way of thinking, there was a saying.
他们说啊，君子要用三不朽，就是追求三种不同的朽坏。
It says that a person should pursue after three things that do not perish.
他们以君子这三不朽，也常常来教导下一代，教导子孙们。
And they often use this to teach their descendants.
叫做立功，要立下功劳，要立下品德，要立下你的言语。
To accomplish to have
要有一个品德的模范
，to have a virtue，
还要有一个言语的模范
，and also have values in speech。
啊，立功、立德、立言，然后把希望子孙们能够达到这三大成就。
So they hope that their descendants can achieve these three things。
在这种极端教导、争取留下名字的氛围当中
，and in these attempts to leave their name behind，
就产生出。有人啊，如果没有办法万古流芳，那流芳就是留名啦、
啊。So if people are unable to leave their name，
那也要遗臭万年呐、啊，要把他的臭名留到万年之久啊。
They should also try for their name to be infamous for years。
所以在中国古代有一个自立为王的，姓李的。
So back in the day there was a person who crown themselves king.
他是在我不要讲朝代了，因为这里有些其他朋友、哦、他当初啊，杀了几十万人啊。
At the time, he killed tens of thousands of people.
他为自己这个杀人还找了很好的借口。
And for killing these people, he had great excuses.
哦，这个就是 明末的闯王李自成啊，不用翻译没关系的。他还立了一个碑来纪念自己杀了七类人的理由啊。
And he even awarded himself and made himself a trophy for killing seven types of people.
你看，他即使自己留下了这种名声，他也觉得好。
Even though he left behind such a reputation, he still thought it was good.
但是我们现在要想想，那我们基督徒呢？
And now we must think, what about us Christians?
我们基督徒其实要轻看自己的名字跟名声。
We should actually not place so much emphasis on our name and our reputation.
若从圣经里面属灵的观点，我们来观察世界上的万物。
If we observe the world's creation from the Bible's perspective,
我们在这个人间所留下来伟大的功劳。
The accomplishments that we leave behind in this world,
美好的品德,
the good virtues,
以及那些不得了的言语,
and all the speech,
没有一个是能够带进天国的,
not one can we bring to heaven.
在天国里面不但用不着,
it is not only that we cannot use in heaven,
而且通常也不是神所纪念的,
and often it is not what God remembers.
所以圣经里面告诉我们将来有一天叫做世界末日,
and the Bible tells us there will be the last day.
到时候留在世界上再大再好的功名,
at that time, no matter how much you accomplish in this world,
不管你在世界上有多少人纪念你,
no matter how many people remember you in this world,
有立了多少的纪念碑,
how many trophies that you have,
因为圣经告诉我们, 我们所存的世界有一天好像会卷衣服一样, 全部被消灭了。
The Bible tells us that one day this world it will roll away.
到时候没有这个时间跟空间。
There will be no time and space.
所以那一些在人世上被纪念的，也将随着这一个时空一起被灭掉。
So those who are remembered in this world, they will also disappear.
即使是存在所有的人心当中，那个时候也没有任何一个人能够留存，所以也都不复存在了。
And even if they are in people's hearts at that time, no one remains.
可是虽然在人世上的功名似乎是暂时的。
So these accomplishments in this world are temporary.
但是我们说啊，所谓的沽名钓誉之事啊，就是一直在努力追求自己名声的这些人。
So these people who continuously pursue after their own name,
却在人世当中腐蚀皆是，就是到处都有。
There are many everywhere.
所以有一句话说，始头无名，始尾无名的事，很少人会去问。指头就是在纸上面啊，只要没有提到我的名字的这种事啊，基本上大家都不是很有兴趣。
So many are not interested in anything that will not leave a mark behind.
所以啊，我到纽西兰基督城，没有看到华人传统的宗教。
So when I came to New Zealand, I have not seen the typical Chinese tradition religion.
但是在我所住的那个台湾啊，有很多在拜其他神明的庙宇。
But where I live in Taiwan, there are many temples that worship other gods.
哇，里面啊，这整个庙宇简直就是艺术品。
The temple is like a piece of art.
我们叫做雕龙画栋啊，里面的那些柱子啊，都雕了非常的精美。
So all of the pillars, the poles in the temple are all beautiful.
有时候里面的一根柱子，它的价值就抵得上我们之间的一间房子。
Sometimes one pillar may be the value of a house.
我曾经看过那柱子上面除了雕刻之外还有什么呢？
And when I looked at the pillar, what else was there on there?
哇，上面刻着很多名字。
There are many names.
那些名字其实就是把钱捐出来来建造庙宇的人。
So they are the names of the people who donated to help build the temple.
所以人间街头巷尾利自己的名字，提自己的字，到处都是。
So there are people who leave their names everywhere.
可是大家要知道，圣经告诉我们，人想要像神一样，把自己的名字被大家纪念啊。
So the Bible is telling us that people like they want to be like God, that their name is remembered by all.
这种想要像神，就是变如神的心态，就是堕落的起点。
So to this heart of wanting to be like God is the beginning of your fall.
所以圣经里面记载第一件事就是
地面上的人们，他们想要纪念自己的名啊，结果被神的愤怒给毁灭了。
So the first event that was recorded in the Bible was when people wanted to remember their own name and therefore were destroyed by God.
我们来看创世纪十一章第四节。
If we look at Genesis chapter 11 verse 4.
请看创世纪十一章第四节。
Genesis chapter 11 verse 4.
他们说来吧，我们要建造一座城和一座塔，塔顶通天，为要传扬我们的名，免得我们分散在全地上。
Then they said, Come, let us build ourselves a city and a tower with its top in the heavens, and let us make a name for ourselves, otherwise we shall be scattered abroad on the face of the whole earth.
来，各位看看，今天我们在会堂里面有各式语言、各式种族的好朋友们。
So we see today that within the church there are people who speak different languages coming from all sorts of backgrounds.
为什么我们还要翻译啊？
Why do we need an interpreter?
为什么言语怎么有这么多种啊？
Why there so many languages?
所以以前我们花很多时间在学语言啊。
So we have spent a lot of time on learning languages.
啊，我以前也学英语学得很苦啊。
I once learned English very earnestly.
我小时候常常在想啊，为什么我这么倒霉要学英文啊？
When I was younger, I would think, why do I need to learn English?
我想要拿那个时间出去玩啊。
I want to take this time and go out to play.
我后来不只学英文啊，还学日文，还学德文啊，准备去留学啊。
Later on, I not only learned English, but also Japanese and German.
诶，这里告诉我们，有这么多的语言，就是在创世纪十一章，因为一开始人都是讲一样的话诶。
And the reason for all of these languages is recorded here because in the beginning everyone spoke the same language.
可是他们想建一个塔来传扬人类自己的名。
But because they wanted to build this tower to proclaim their own names.
这个塔就是我们现在所称的巴别塔。
So this tower is called the Tower of Babel.
所以接下来大家有空去看后面的经文了，神就毁掉这个塔，而且变乱了他们的口音。
So God ruined this tower and he confused their languages.
这是我们今天为什么要学习这么多语言，花费这么多时间的原因。
And this is why we need to spend so much time and learn so many languages.
哇，语言啊，就成了我们今天沟通的一种障碍哦。有时候这种不同的语言。
And languages have become a possible communication barrier.
它的原因就是因为人想纪念自己的名，像神一样。
And the reason for this is because people wanted to be like God for their own names to be remembered.
我们来看撒母旧约圣经撒母耳记上十五章第十节。
We look at 1 Samuel chapter 15 verse 10.
撒母耳记上十五章的十节到十二节。
First Samuel chapter 15 verse 10 to 12.
耶和华的话临到撒母耳说：“我立扫罗为王，我后悔了，因为他转去不跟从我，不遵守我的命令。”撒母耳便甚忧愁，终夜哀求耶和华。撒母耳清早起来迎接扫罗，有人告诉撒母耳说：“扫罗到了加密，在那里立了纪念碑，又转身下到基甲。”
So 10, the word of the Lord came to Samuel 11. I regret that I made Saul king, for he has turned back from following me, and he has not carried out my commands. Samuel was angry, and he cried out to the Lord all night. 12. Samuel rose early in the morning to meet Saul, and Samuel was told, Saul went to Carmel, where he set up a monument for himself, and when on returning, he passed down to Gilgal.
我们在这里看到三千多年前，本来神立了一个地上的王。
So here we see about 3,000 years ago, God had a king in this world.
对，这个王叫做扫罗。
And this king was called King Saul.
可是这个王后来啊，他对神变心啦。
But later on, his heart towards God changed.
他骄傲啦。
He became proud.
他没有忠心为神，反而为自己设想。
So he thought not for God, but for himself.
所以这里神说啊，哎呀。这个人要换啦、啊，后悔就是要换他啦。
So God thought that he needs to be, he needs to step down from his position.
我们刚才看到的十二节里面讲说，这个人变心啦、啊，第一件做的事是什么呢
？And here we see what it was the first thing that he did.
立了纪念碑，有看到吗
？He set up a monument for himself.
我们不知道这个纪念碑是纪念他的名，还是纪念他的功绩呀、啊？
And we don't know that if this was to remember his name or for his accomplishments.
大家要注意，开始纪念自己了。
So he started to remember himself.
我们在其实圣经有另外两个地方，时间关系我们不翻了。
There are two other places in the Bible, but due to time constraints, we won't go there.
在旧约圣经撒母耳记下十八章的十八节。
In First Samuel chapter 18, verse 18.
那里记载了，哎，大卫的一个儿子叫亚沙龙啊，他也立了一个柱子，留下自己的名声。
Here it mentions David's son. He also set up a monument to remember himself.
可是我们今天在做神所亲爱的。
But here, seated here, the beloved ones of God.
在我们只要知道，在圣经里面真正有意义的名字是要留在哪里，这样就好了。
It's good as long as we know where what is important to remember.
我们的名字不是要留在世界上。
Our names are not to be left in this world.
要留在哪里呢
？Where should it be left?
我们来看旧约圣经马拉基书第三章。
If we look at Malachi chapter 3,
十六节
，verse 16.
马拉基书三章十六节。
Malachi chapter 3, verse 16.
那时敬畏耶和华的彼此谈论，耶和华侧耳而听，且有纪念册在他面前，记录那敬畏耶和华、思念他名的人。Amen.
16. Then those who revered the Lord spoke with one another. The Lord took note and listened, and a book of remembrance was written before him of those who revered the Lord and thought on his name.
这个耶和华就是在耶稣还没有降生之前。旧约时期的人对神的称呼。
So, in the Old Testament, before Jesus was born, the people called God Lord.
所以神没有两位、三位，神从来都只有一位是独一的。
So, there's always only been one God.
现在我们不再称神为耶和华，因为我们知道他给了我们一个名字，叫做耶稣。
And now we no longer call God Lord because we know that He has a name called Jesus.
所以耶稣就是神啊。
So Jesus is God.
这里十六节告诉我们，在神的面前有一本纪念册。
So here it tells us that before the Lord there is a book of remembrance.
这个纪念册放的不是相片。
And there are no photos, it's not for photos.
这个纪念册里面记载了所有的名字，那敬畏神的人的名。
It records the names of all who fear the Lord.
其实就是将来能够得到永生、进入天国的那些的名字啊。
So it's the name of those who will receive eternal life and enter into heaven.
基督徒不会为了名声而来存活。
So Christians will not live for their name.
我们都是神的儿女。
We are all children of God.
主今天借着真理的圣灵也住在我们身体里面。
And God's Holy Spirit lives within us.
所以耶稣基督告诉我们，我们要活出他的样式来。
So Christ Jesus told us that we must live out His image.
如果别人觉得我们好
，If others think that we are good，
那是因为他们跟我们接触之后，有感受到神的存在。
That's because after interacting with us, they can feel the presence of God.
好像经文讲的，我们披戴基督了。
So it's like wearing Christ.
我们不为人间留名来信主。
We do not believe in God to leave our name in this world.
但是我们要记住，凡是一个真正信主的人，天上的神每一个名字他都知道。
But for everyone that believes in God, He knows our names.
我们来看旧约圣经诗篇一百四十七篇。
If we look at Psalm 147,
一百四十七篇的第四节。
Psalm 147, verse 4.
他数点星宿的数目，一一称他的名。
He determines the number of the stars. He gives to all of them their names.
各位，这第四节啊，就是人类永远办不到的事啊。
So verse 4, it is what a man can never achieve.
大家知道吗？这个宇宙里面的星宿啊，数目有多多，我们数都数不来。
There are so many stars in this universe we cannot count.
不要说太阳系这几颗星球。
Let alone the galaxy.
我们在银河系里面呢、啊，银河的星星就好多啊。
Just in the Milky Way, there are so many stars.
然后这个银河系又只不过是许多星系里面数都数不过来里面的一个。
And this is only one of many.
所以
小弟常常觉得我的软弱，有时候记人名记不太住。
So I personally think that one of my weaknesses is that I can't remember names.
我们有些前辈跟同工啊，好有恩赐去记人的名字。
Some of our fellow workers have great talents in remembering names.
有时候你20年不见他，他一看见你就叫出了你的名字。
Sometimes if you have not seen them for 20 years, they will recognize you by your name.
他不只记得你的名字啊，他还记得你整个家族里面的名字。
Not only will they know your name, but also the names of everyone in your family.
小弟常常是有时候看见你，我明明知道你是哪个家位是，我认识你，突然就忘了名字。
Sometimes I will see you and I remember which church you're from, but I cannot remember your name.
可是没有关系啊，我们的神全部记得我们。
That's okay because God remembers every one of us.
这是人办不到的。
This is what a man cannot achieve.
人类不管有几十亿、有几兆的名字，神都一一记得，从不忘记。
God remembers every single name and he never forgets.
其实天上的神期待我们在座的每一个，像约翰福音里面这个无名的门徒一样。
So God looks forward to every one of us, just like this unnamed disciple in the Gospel of John.
主也期待他的教会里面有更多这一些无名的门徒。
And he also looks forward to more unnamed disciples in his church.
因为我们这些跟随耶稣的人，我们的名字应该留在生命册里面呢。
Because as followers of Christ, our name should be saved in the book of remembrance.
不需要刻意留在人间的历史上。
Not in the history of this world.
我们想想，在圣经里面这一些今天被几十亿人传颂的名字，其实好像没有留在人的历史上啊。
Just like many of these names that are remembered in the Bible, they may not be in mankind's history.
像我们在旧约圣经但以理书所读到的但以理。
Just like in the book of Daniel, where it mentions Daniel.
哇，他在历史上没有留下资料哎。
There is no information on him in history.
留下资料名字的是但以理服侍的那个王叫尼布甲尼撒。
The only name in his time was the king that he served, King Nebuchadnezzar.
可是将来你在天上可能遇不见那个王呢。
But maybe in the future you may not meet this king in heaven.
我们大家都知道的使徒保罗。
And we know apostles Paul.
他也是在历史的记载里面，你几乎找不到他的名字。
It's similarly you cannot find his name in history.
历史上常常找到的资料是保罗那个时代的罗马皇帝内罗尼洛。
Often what you will find in his time was.The king of his time, which was King Nero.
但是将来在神永生的国度里面，你会遇到谁呢？
But in God's kingdom, who will you meet?
人间留下的名字留不到永远。
The names left in this world, they are temporary.
甚至我们所说做教会圣工的这些事情，
even doing divine work in church,
也是这样。
It's similar.
我们不是要追求被人家赞赏的。这些绩效
We're not pursuing after being praised by others.
我们也不是为了让人家在将来在教会的历史里面圣经纪念刊上面看见我们的名字。
And it's not to, for others to see us in the church's history book.
我们更不是希望说我们做了多少所以让所有的信徒都认识我们。
And it's not that we do so much for people to know us.
人单单是人想要被人家知道我自己呀、啊。这个动机就成不了主所爱的。
So with the motive of wanting others to know oneself, that is not what God likes.
所以我们能够清楚认知自己的名字到底要在哪里，不用在哪里，这个可以让我们成为主所爱的。
So we must know where we want our name to be.
接下来我们从约翰福音里面发现，约翰福音有一个很重要的主题。
Just like in the Gospel of John, there is a very important topic.
这个主题大家一定要读出来，就是神与人的同住这个主题。
And it is the common dwelling, the coexistence of God and man.
这在约翰福音一开头就这样告诉我们了。
And it tells us at the start of the Gospel of John.
我们现在来看约翰福音第一章。
If we turn to the Gospel of John, chapter 1.
约翰福音一章的第一节。
John chapter 1, verse 1.
跟第二节。
And verse 2.
太初有道，道与神同在，道就是神。这道太初与神同在。
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God.
来，大家注意到这里，在强调同在。
So here it's emphasizing on coexistence.
这种同在后来改变呢
？And then later on, this changes.
改变成什么形态呢？我们看第十四节。
It changes into verse 14.
道成了肉身，住在我们中间，充充满满的有恩典，有真理。我们也见过他的荣光，正是父独生子的荣光。
And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen His glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
所以这些话，话本来是摸不见、看不见的。
So originally these words, you cannot see it or feel it.
结果现在成了肉身来住在我们中间。
And now it has become flesh and come to live among us.
这个住在我们中间，在前面马太福音一章二十一节用另外四个字来表达了。
And this living among us.
四个中文呢、啊、
？It was represented in the Chinese version of Matthew chapter 1.
叫做以马内利。
Called Emmanuel.
以马内利就是神与我们同在。
Emmanuel means God is with us.
大家知道吗？神，我请问大家，你们渴望跟神同住吗
？And I ask you, do you wish to live with God?
哎，有人点头了，感谢主。
And thank God there are people who have not.
可是如果现在有人说啊，哎，有要跟神同住，那我不是现在就要离世了吗
？Some people may say, to live with God, does that mean that I must leave this world now?
好，没关系，大家回去再慢慢想。可是小弟告诉大家，不管你现在有没有很想跟神马上同住
，Whether you really want to live with God now or not，
圣经从第一卷到最后一卷，你会发觉神。非常非常想跟我们同住。
You'll realize from the first to the last book of the Bible, God really wants to live with us.
我们也可以说，从我们认识神开始啊，神一向的心愿就是想要跟他所造的人住在一起啊。
And from the very beginning, since we've known Him, God's one wish is to live with His people.
我们又常常讲另外一个字，叫做我们希望与神同行。
And we also often say that we wish to walk with God.
可是注意，我们现在所讲的是同住，还不只是同行而已、啊。
But now we're speaking of living together, not only walking together.
从与主同住的经历里面。
So from the experience of living with God.
这就是约翰福音这个作者主所爱的门徒他信仰的起点。
This was the starting point of the faith of the author of the Gospel of John.
他体会到他之所以能够认识神。
He said that only he could only get to know God.
他对神一切的知识跟尝试。
All of his knowledge and his experiences with God.
都是来自于神选择与他同住开始。
It started because God chose to live with him.
我们来看约翰福音十四章的第九节。
If we look at John chapter 14 verse 9.
请看约翰福音十四章第九节。
John chapter 14 verse 9。
耶稣对他说：“腓力，我与你们同在这样长久，你还不认识我吗？人看见了我，就是看见了父。你怎么说将父显给我们看呢
？”Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you all this time, Philip, and you still do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'?"
耶稣其实是在讲一件事。
So Jesus here, he's talking or something.
你们跟我同住这么久，你们应该对我有最深刻、最完整的认识。
So you've lived with me for so long, you should know me the best.
所以有时候你们觉得我这个信赖的还不错。
Sometimes you think that I'm not bad.
那是因为你没有跟小弟同住啊。
Well, that's because you haven't lived with me.
你可能住久了，你就会发现我很多地方都错了。
After living with one for a while, you may think that I have many weaknesses.
人跟人之间的关系，有时候保持一点距离，好像很美好。
When people keep a distance from another, sometimes they will be seen as very good.
可是有时候住在一起呀，你就会发现彼此都有缺点。
But when you live together, you'll realize that everyone has their weaknesses.
所以前几天。我们去访问一位慕道朋友。
So a few days ago, we went to visit a truth seeker.
他也诚实的说啊，啊，我们夫妻之间啊，有时候有很多问题呀、啊。
And they honestly said that between husband and wife, we have many issues.
我说这个很正常啊。
And I said that this is very normal.
不要说夫妻之间，今天各位来到教会里面啊，你会发觉人跟人之间总是会有问题，会有冲突的。
Not just between husband and wife, but even between people in the church, there's always conflict.
因为我们都不完全，我们都带着软弱。
Because we are all incomplete, we all have weaknesses.
所以耶稣基督才会一而再、再而三的一直告诉我们一个道理，叫做彼此饶恕，互相代祷。
So that's why Jesus Christ constantly teaches us to forgive one another and intercede.
我们再想回来，所以同住时候的认识是最深入的、最亲密的认识。
So when you get to know one through living together, you know them very closely.
今天我们如何去认识我们的神是独一的？
So how do we get to know that our God is true and only one?
今天在耶稣教会里面，我们讲一神。
Today in True Jesus Church, we say one God.
我们为什么没有像其他主流的基督教派说，好像是三位一体？
Why do we not believe in Trinity?
因为我们借着圣灵降临，跟我们同住了，所以我们知道不用讲三四五，而是一。
Because we know that when the Holy Spirit comes upon us, it lives with us, it is one.
我们的信仰跟旧约时候的百姓是一样的。
Our faith is the same as the faith of those in the Old Testament.
我们的信仰跟2000年前使徒教会以及耶稣基督教导我们的是一样的。
Our faith is the same as the faith of the Apostle Church and the faith that Jesus has taught us.
所以主耶稣强调啊，我们的神是独一的神，主耶稣自己这样讲，没有说三一啊。
Jesus said himself that our God is the one true God. There is no three different gods.
然后新约经文里面告诉我们，一主、一信、一神、一喜、一神，对不对？
So the Bible tells us that there is one truth, one word, one God.
所以这就是我们领受的。
So this is what we have
received. 为什么我们领受的这么深刻呢？因为神借着圣灵来与我们同住了。
And we have received this so well because God has lived with us through the Holy Spirit.
神想要跟所爱的人住在一起。
He wants to live with who he loves.
有时候我们不一定有这样的渴望。
Often, sometimes we may not have this want.
所以我常常有些听到有些父母长辈说，孩子独立了，让他们出去吧。
Sometimes I hear parents say that the children have grown up, let them be.
我们也渐渐习惯这样子的生活了。
And we're very used to this type of lifestyle.
有时候想到孩子，又蛮想念的。
And when we think of our children, we may miss them.
我们的年轻人也被训练说，我们要赶快独立。
And the younger ones have been taught to be independent.
我在台湾问我们那边的大学生说，哎呀，你们多久没打电话回家啦？
But in Taiwan, I asked the university students, how long have you not called home?
我说每天打电话回去跟爸爸妈妈讲几句话的举手，喂，大家都有手机啊，没人举手啊。
Everyone has a phone, but nobody put their hand up when I asked who calls their parents every day.
每天可以跟朋友，好像不讲讲话就快死掉了，可以每天不用跟父母讲话。
So it's as if they're gonna die if they don't text their friends for a day, but they don't text their parents every day.
然后我问他们说，那每个礼拜有打回去的举手？哎，有一些举手了。
So then I asked who calls home every week, and some raised their hand.
我说每个月打回去的举手，又有一些举手了。
And I asked how many call once a month, and some more put their hands up.
哎，我注意到里面啊，有十几二十个，因为那是差不多300人啊，哈，的大学生啊。
And because there were around 300 university students, there were about 10 to 20.
我注意到里面有二三十个都没有举手啊。
There were about 20 to 30 who never raised their hand.
那我就问他们说，哎，那请问你们大概什么时候打电话回去啊？
So I asked him, when do you call home?
他们说，啊，有有有，哎，月底账户快没有钱的时候，我就会打回去了。
They said I do, but it's at the end of the month when I'm running out of money.
所以当中有个妈妈说啊，只要电话一响，我就知道我儿子要打电话来说什么了。妈，我没钱了。
So there was a mother who said that once my phone rings, I know what my son is going to say.
各位亲爱的弟兄姐妹，我们信耶稣啊，我觉得最好不要信到变这个样子。
So I hope that believing in Jesus, we don't turn into this.
虽然我们常常鼓励说，当你觉得你生活当中有需要的时候，你就随时跪下来。向神来祈求。
Although we do say that when you face difficulties, you should pray.
因为神也给我们这样的应许，说我们叩门，他就开门；我们祈求，他就给我们。
Because God has promised us when we knock on the door, He will open the door.
可是这个只是信仰的起点啊。
But this is only the beginning, starting point of our faith.
我们不要像年轻人一样，我缺钱的时候才打电话给父母啊。
We should not be like the young ones, only calling our parents.
我们跟神相处的方式。
So this should be our communication method with God.
所以有时候啊，我们希望从神得恩典，但是我们不一定很渴望跟神马上住在一起。
So sometimes that we hope for blessings from God, but we do not want to immediately live with God.
可是刚才我们讲到，整本圣经告诉我们，神非常希望跟他所造的儿女住在一起。
But the whole Bible tells us that God really wants to live with His children.
从他一造伊甸园，造了亚当夏娃，就每天跟他们在那里走啊，对不对
？Since He created the Garden of Eden and Adam and Eve, He was walking with them every day.
然后后来他常常降临到地面上来，不是只以耶稣基督的形态来哦。
And then He would often come into this world, not only in the form of Jesus.
亚伯拉罕遇到了神。
Abraham met God.
雅各也遇到了神。
Jacob met God.
摩西也遇到了神。
Moses met God.
约书亚也遇到了那一位元帅。
God, Joshua also met him.
所以神常常来到地面上。
So God often comes into this world.
神带领他的百姓出埃及的时候，吩咐他们的第一件事情就是造那会幕。
And when he led the Israelites out of the wilderness, the first commandment was to build the tabernacle.
会幕啊，出埃及记的会幕，原来就是两个字构成的 compound word。
So the tabernacle is a compound word。
叫做相会的帐篷。
So it is the tent of meeting。
里面所有的样式，里面所有的材料，神都指定好。你看神多重视这件事。
Everything in there, how everything set out, and all of the materials God had prepared.
我们把会幕当作是一个神圣的宗教场所。
So we see it as a holy place.
其实神啊，就是希望在地面上有个地方，他来跟他所爱的人相会、约会啊。
So he hopes for there to be a place where he meets his beloved people.
他要借着会幕住在他的百姓当中。
And through the tabernacle, he wanted to dwell among his people.
后来借着圣殿住在他们当中。
And then later on, through the temple, he would live among them.
现在圣殿已经不在了，他借着什么样的形式呢
？And now there is no longer a temple, so how does he come?
我们来看约翰福音十四章的十六节。
If we look at John chapter 14, verse 16.
约翰福音十四章十六节。
John chapter 14, verse 16.
我要求父。父就另外赐给你们一位保惠师，叫他永远与你们同在。
And I will ask the Father, and He will give you another advocate to be with you forever.
我们继续看二十节。
We'll look at verse 20.
到那日，你们就知道我在父里面，你们在我里面，我也在你们里面。
On that day, you will know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you.
好，我们继续看二十三节。
And verse 23.
耶稣说：“人若爱我，就必遵守我的道。我父也必爱他，并且我们要到他那里去，与他同住。”
Jesus answered him, "Those who love me will keep my word, and my Father will love them, and we will come to them and make a home with them."
各位，这种同住不是想象出来的。
So this living together, it is not imaginary.
以前小弟遇到一个大学生，他来到我们真耶稣教会。
Once I met a university student who came to True Jesus Church.
然后我们跟他分享说，今天神借着他应许真理的圣灵，我们求就能领受住在我们里面。
And I told them that, I shared that through God's promised Holy Spirit, He lives in us.
他是从其他教会过来的。
He had come from a different church.
他听了，他把这句话拿回去问他们的 pastor。
He took this sentence and he went to ask the pastor.
结果那个 pastor 很不高兴。
And the pastor was unhappy.
因为那个大学生后来告诉我说，因我觉得要求圣灵啊。
Because then the university student said that.
我回去问我原来的牧师，结果他说，你怎么可以这么没信心呢？
He said that he thinks he should ask for the Holy Spirit. And
你要相信自己已经有圣灵了。
His pastor said, "Why do you have no faith? You should
believe that you have the Holy Spirit." 你没有圣灵，怎么会承认耶稣是主呢？
How do you recognize God? Jesus is God.
你没有圣灵，怎么会想读圣经呢？
If you don't have the Holy Spirit, how would you want to read the Bible?
所以我们很多教派的朋友们吧。圣灵的感动误解成圣灵的同住啦。
So a lot of people have think that the movement by the Holy Spirit is the dwelling of the Holy Spirit.
感谢主，这一个 年轻人，他很快领受圣灵。
And we thank God that this young person received the Holy Spirit.
他才知道以前我那种想象啊，不是真实的。
And then he knew that his original imagination was not real.
对，这样很奇怪啊，明明我的儿子已经肚子饿了。
So this is very interesting. So it's like if my son is already hungry.
他就真的没有吃到什么东西。
But he has not actually eaten anything.
结果他进来了，找爸爸说：“爸爸，我肚子饿哎。”
And he comes to his father and asks, that I'm hungry.
然后我还要妈妈说：“你怎么可以这么没有信心呢？”
Then and it's like if I scold him and say that, how do you have, why do you have no faith?
你明明就是饱的。
You are full.
对呀、啊，你祷告之后，你 say grace 之后就饱了。
After you say grace, you were full.
哎呀，我们知道。领受应许的圣灵，我们是摸的，是看得见，也听得到，也有感受。
So we know that receiving the Holy Spirit, we can see it, we can feel it, and we can hear it.
所以刚才告诉我们，神赐下这个保惠师要跟我们同在，让他在我们里面。主耶稣还没有赐下，就先这样讲了。
So he is to live within us. Jesus said this.
那神跟我们同在的第二个方式。就是借由让我们领受他的肉跟血。
And another way to live with us is for us to partake of his blood and his body.
我们来看约翰福音六章五十三节。
We look at John chapter 6, verse 53.
约翰福音六章五十三节。
John chapter 6, verse 53.
大家有没有发现这些经文都在约翰福音里面
？Do you realize that all of these verses are in the book Gospel of John?
这就是小弟讲的约翰福音一个很重要的主题，就是神的同在，特别是同住啊。
And this is what I'm saying that a very important theme of John is God's living with us.
我们从五十三节看到五十六节。
So from verse 53 to 56.
请翻译来念。
So Jesus said to them, Very truly I tell you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. 54. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. 55. For my flesh is the true food, and my blood is true drink. 56. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in them.
所以神今天如何跟我们同在跟同住，除了赐下圣灵，就是我们以无罪的身份领受他的肉跟血。
So to coexist and live with us today, apart from receiving the Holy Spirit, it is to partake of His blood and His flesh.
这个肉跟血不是以饱足为目的啊。
And this blood and flesh is not to fill us.
你看这个前后的经文告诉我们，这要成就一个属灵的奥秘。
It is to fulfill a mystery of the Spirit.
让我们跟耶稣能够合一。
So that we can become one with Jesus.
让耶稣已经复活过的样式，将来在末日来到的时候，也发生在我们身上，让我们在末日能够复活。
So it is so that we can be like Jesus and resurrect on the last day.
今天是因为耶稣还没再临，他借着圣灵跟领受圣餐跟我们同在的。
And because Jesus has not come again yet, he is with us through our part.
各位亲爱的，你们知道吗？今天我们还有个很大的盼望。
But today we have a great hope.
将来我们会发生什么事呢
？What will happen in the future？
我们来看约翰福音十四章二节跟三节。
We look at John chapter 14, verse 2 to 3.
约翰福音十四章的二节跟三节。
John chapter 14, verse 2 to 3.
在我父的家里有许多住处，若是没有，我就早已告诉你们了。我去原是为你们预备地方去。第三节，我若去为你们预备的地方，就必再来接你们到我那里去。我在哪里，叫你们也在哪里。
Two, in my father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? Three, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and I will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also.
各位亲爱的，你们听见吗？这是今天你们坐在这里的原因。
Here we know this is the reason for us to be sitting here today.
我看到当中，感谢主有几位朋友，我们这个礼拜接触，你们今天坐在这里。
And I'm very happy that I'm glad that we are all seated here today.
你们知道吗？我认为不是我的邀请成就的。
I believe that it is not the invitation that fulfilled it.
当然也感谢你们了。
But I still thank for.
但是我认为是主耶稣到你家找你，把你请过来。
I believe it is Jesus going to your house and inviting you to him.
今天我们坐在这里都是因为主耶稣的引导跟允许。
And today we are seated here because of God's guidance and allowance.
所以我们跟这个约翰福音里面那个没有名字的门徒是一样的。
So we are the same as the disciple without a name.
这位无名的门徒他信仰的开始。
This unnamed disciple, the start of his faith.
是神主动来跟他同住。
It was God who went.
就像今天耶稣邀请你们来，也希望跟你们同住啊。
Just like how Jesus wants invites you here today, he wants to live with you.
而这一个无名门徒他的回馈反应是什么呢？
And what was his reaction? What was the unnamed disciple's reaction?
是他愿意一辈子做一个没有名字的人来跟随耶稣基督。
He was willing to be unnamed for the rest of his life to follow Jesus.
但是我们最后还要花几分钟讲。有比同住更亲密的关系，我们要来追求。
And there is a relationship that's even closer than living together that we must pursue.
我们为什么注意到这个关系？就是这个无名的门徒留给我们的线索。
So this relationship is what this unnamed disciple has left for us.
所以这一个主所爱的，他追求的是比一般的信徒更深一层的关系。
So the one that God loves, he pursues after a deeper connection with God.
我们发现主也接受了，而且爱他更多。
And we realize that God has accepted this and loves him more.
是什么关系呢？我们来看约翰福音十三章。
We look at John chapter 13.
十三章的二十一到二十三节。
John chapter 13, verse 21.
耶稣说了这话，心里忧愁，就明说：“我实实在在的告诉你们，你们中间有一个人要卖我了。”二十二节。门徒彼此对看，猜不透所说的是谁。二十三节，有一个门徒是耶稣所爱的，侧身挨进耶稣的怀里。
After saying this, Jesus was troubled in spirit and declared, "Very truly I tell you, one of you will betray me." 22. The disciples looked at one another, uncertain of whom he was speaking. 23. One of his disciples, the one whom Jesus loved, was reclining next to him.
请大家想一想，给大家三秒钟想一想，你在这三节。有感受到什么吗？
Let us think, what have you felt in these three verses?
刚才我们讲同住。
Before we talked of living together.
同住不一定能到入怀的地步啊。
So living together does not mean you're in his arms.
对，想想我们一栋宿舍里面，我读大学的时候要跟其他同学住宿舍。
So if we think of one university hall,
我们在宿舍里面跟多少人同住呢？
In a dormitory, you may live with many people.
我们又跟我们旁边的邻舍已经同住了多久呢？
How long have we lived with the person next to us?
可能原来在我们的地方，我们所谓的大家族，对不对？
So we may refer to it as a big family.
我们要在大家族里面跟多少家人同住呢？
And a big family, how many people do you need to live with?
但是我们发觉很多人同住啊。永远没有办法进到入怀的地步。
But we may realize that even if two people live together, they may never be in each other's arms.
我们想想这个道理。
If we think of this,
同住之后会因着有爱才能够入怀。
In living together, they can only go into each other's arms if there is love.
入怀是同住加上爱的结果。
So, being in each other's arms is a result of living together in love.
没有爱的同住，不但入不了怀，还是一件痛苦的事。
Without love, living together is very not enjoyable.
所以为什么有些人本来同住的，后来要选择分开，对不对？好多人呢。
So some people choose to live together and then separate.
被强逼在一起的同住。
So when they have been forced to live together,
犹如我的身体被限制上封锁起来的疯人院里面是一样的。
It is like your body being held in a mental hospital.
我们想想看，我们在圣经里面读到旧约那一艘方舟，就是渡过大洪水的那一艘船。
So the ark in the Old Testament that went through the flood.
在方舟里面呢，虽然只有八个人。
Although there were only eight people in the ark.
那八个人对那个很大的空间来讲，空间应该够啊。
But for that big place, there should be enough space for eight people.
但是如果没有爱的话，
But if there is no love,
那一艘方舟也只能成为一个悲惨而且封闭的小小世界。
That ark would just be a small world.
除了方舟，必死无疑，因为外面是大水。
But apart from the ark, you will die out of it.
留在方舟里面又要相吞相咬。
And then in the ark, if they had no love, they would have fight.
没有爱的话，再美好的空间，等待的也是无奈跟痛苦啊。
So without love, and no matter how big the space is, it is very unenjoyable to spend that space together.
所以我们发现，在那一个旧约里面的大船，它强调的是什么呢？
So this ark in the Old Testament, what is it emphasizing?
它强调的不是人数的多少，有没有发现
？It is not the number of people.
它强调的是，在这里面的人是一家人啊。
It's that the people in this ark were one family.
这个方舟能够容得下两家人、三家人吗
？Can it fit two or three families?
空间上当然可以啊。
In terms of space, definitely.
但是事实上，它强调的不是这个。
But it is not what it emphasizes.
得救是以家为单位的，我们有些领会者这样分享。
So someone has shared before that salvation is for the family.
大家知道吗？这个家还不只是指着我们实质上的家庭。
It is not referring to our real family in this world.
得救是以家为单位的，其实属灵的意义是指的救恩会临到真正的一家人。
So spiritually, it means that salvation will come upon this true family.
这个真正的一家人在哪里
？And where is this true family?
我知道你们有各自的家庭，感谢主。
And we thank God, everyone has their own family.
但是不管你家里面有多少人信主，还是都没有信主。
But no matter how many people believe or don't believe in your family.
你今天来到这里，绝对不只是一个组织。
And when you come here, it is not just an organization.
我们也不是来搞团体活动。
We're not here for fellowship.
你来到这里，一定要感受。我们今天在这里，我们成为属灵的一家人了。
You must feel that today here we become a spiritual family.
我们有血缘上的家人，今天主赐你更多的家人。
We have a blood-related family, but today God gives you a greater family.
所以我们要相爱如一家人。
So we must love one another like a family.
所以我们彼此称为弟兄姐妹。
So we call each other brothers and sisters.
我们有同样一位天父。
We have the same Father.
我们同领一个圣灵。
We have the same Holy Spirit.
我们有同样的信仰。
We have the same faith.
我们将来有同样的盼望。
And we have the same hope.
所以这是神对他百姓的应许。
So this is the promise from God to His people.
那我们请看最后两节。
So look at the last two verses.
我们来看旧约圣经申命记33:12。
So we look at the Old Testament Ecclesiastes.
申命记33:12。
Sorry, Deuteronomy chapter 3:22。
申命记33:12。
Deuteronomy chapter 33.
论便雅悯说，耶和华所亲爱的必同耶和华安然居住，耶和华终日遮蔽他，也住在他两间之中。
So Deuteronomy chapter 33 verse 12 of Benjamin, he said, "The beloved of the Lord rests in safety. The high God surrounds him all day long. The beloved rests between his shoulders."
大家特别注意这一节经文。
So here,
这里说神所爱的神，他会跟神安然居住。
The beloved of the Lord rests in safety.
大家有没有发现，第一个不只想跟你同住，还想入到你怀中的？其实不是我们人啊，是神哎。
So the one who wants to live with you and in your arms is not man but God.
我们可能还不一定体会到跟神要有这么亲密的关系，而是神主动想跟我们有这么亲密的关系。
God takes initiative to want to have this relationship with us.
这里说也住在他两肩之中。
And here it says to rest between his shoulders.
两肩之中难道指的是我们的头和脖子吗
？Is it our head and neck?
没有，两肩之中指的是我们的心怀啊。
No, it is referring to our heart.
是我们的怀抱啊。
Our embrace, bosom.
所以神一开始就希望住在我们的怀中。
So from the very beginning, God wishes to live within us.
那我们呢？我们应该怎么样想呢
？And how should we think of it?
我们来看最后一节。
If we look at the last verse.
请看旧约圣经诗篇131篇。
Psalm 131.
诗篇131篇。
Psalm 131.
的第二节。
Verse 2.
我的心平稳安静，好像断过奶的孩子在他母亲的怀中。我的心在我里面，真像断过奶的孩子。
But I have calmed and quieted my soul like a weaned child with its mother. My soul is like the weaned child that is with me.
神来到我们两肩之中。
God comes between our shoulders.
那我们应该感受到的，就像这一节所讲。
And so we should feel just like this.
什么叫做断过奶的孩子？
What does it mean to be a weaned child?
我们华人有一句话叫做形容说，使尽吃奶的力气。
So there is a phrase in Chinese saying that we use all the energy like drinking milk.
哇，你看那个婴儿啊，在吸母乳的时候，他多认真，多用力啊！
When looking at
他在生存啊。
An infant to when they're being breastfed, they use all of the energy.
所以当他完成这件事情之后，他好像累垮了，就安然入睡。
So when they finish this, it's like they're so tired they go to sleep.
你想想，在母亲的怀中。
So in the embrace of a mother.
外面可能有没有可能发生 cyclone 啊？
There could be a cyclone.
飓风啊？有没有可能地震啊？
There could be an earthquake.
有没有可能战争瘟疫啊？
There could be war or a plague.
我们有时候想到这些事情就忧愁害怕。
When we think of these, we may be scared.
可是就像那个婴儿在母亲的怀中，他吃饱了，他睡着了。
But just like an infant in the arms of their mother, they have eaten and they're asleep.
感受一下。外面那些大风大浪跟他一点关系都没有，他睡得多安稳。
Everything going on outside has nothing to do with him.
我们今天在我们的信仰里面，在神的灵里面，我们要体会到这种层次才对呀。
So today in our faith, in our spirits, we must feel to this level.
所以你看那主所爱的那一位门徒，他跟耶稣吃晚餐之后，还钻进耶稣的怀里啊。
So the beloved disciple of Christ, after dining with Christ, he went into his bosom.
那是他追求。
This is what he pursued after.
难道不也是我们应当追求的？
And is it not what we should as well?
当我们希望跟神同住。
When we wish to live with God.
甚至入神的怀中。
Or even enter into God's bosom.
我们就是那主所爱的门徒。
We are that beloved disciple of God.
约翰福音故意不写出这个名字，就是要让在座诸位你们对号入座，因为你就是那一位才对。
And the Gospel of John does not mention a name because you are that beloved disciple.
所以你是主所爱的门徒吗？
So are you this beloved disciple of the Lord?
早上我们见证到这里。
So our testimony this morning ends here.
一起来唱诗。
We'll rise to sing hymn.
赞美诗388首。
Hymn number 388.